हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड यू एंजॉयड योर समर वेकेशंस आल्सो, एज देयर वर नो क्लासेस. बट नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट आवर क्लासेस. सो वेलकम बैक टू आवर ई क्लास ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स. टुडे द टॉपिक वी विल स्टडी इज स्टोरी सम. I am Anukriti Gupta, your mathematics teacher. Now, let's get started with today's topic. Students, let's have a quick revision of what we learned before summer vacations. We learned addition on number line and subtraction on number line. We also learned the concept of zero, that if we subtract or add any number to zero, the result will be the same as the number which we are adding or subtracting. Here I have given you examples to revise it. Also, last week we did our book work and worksheets related to the same topic. Let's get started with our today's topic now, which is addition story sums. Addition story sums. Students, if you have your books with you, you can open page number 29. It will be helpful for you to understand. Now, what are story sums? In maths, addition stories are a form of word problems in which children read written questions to determine what sum to answer. You might be confused. Now let me explain this to you in simple words. Story sums are basically word problems. Word problems in which information is given, and in spite of mathematical notation, there are reading questions by which we will form a sum and then we will solve it. For example, there are 8 apples on a tree and I found that there are 4 more apples on the other side of the tree. So now, this will be in a form of a story, and I have to make a sum out of it. So I'll pick number 8 and 4 more. That means plus 4. 8 plus 4. So whatever the sums come out to be, the result will be, the answer will be that particular number. You might be confused. Let's solve this with some example, or just look out for some example. I'll explain it to you in a better manner. Now, let us understand word problem or story sums with these three examples. I will read out the questions for you and then will tell you the solutions and how will we solve it in our books also. Number 1. Tom has 3 yellow pencils and 2 red pencils. How many pencils does he have? Now students, in the first box, we will write the number of pencils he is having. The number of yellow pencils he is having. That is 3. Plus the number of red pencils he is having. That is 2. 3 plus 2 equals 5. Yes. Now, in our books, we will write the solution in vertical sums. I will provide you the worksheet and the file for you to understand and write it in proper manner. In these questions, we have solved the sums in horizontal manner. Question number 2. There are 4 roses and 2 sunflowers in my garden. How many flowers are there in all? So we know there are 4 roses, that means 4, plus 2 sunflowers, that means 2, equals to 6. Third question. 5 boys were playing in the ground. 3 girls also joined in, that means 5 boys were playing in a ground and then 3 friends, they are girls, also come and join them. How many kids are there? Now we have to tell them how many total kids are there. So 5 plus 3 equals to 8. Yes, this is how we will solve it in our books also, but we will write the question or the sum in the vertical manner. Let's move to the next topic now. Let's come to page number 30 in your books now, which is subtraction story sums. Students, addition story sums and subtraction story sums are almost same. In both the story sums, we will read the question, we will frame a question or a sum, and then we will solve it. In addition, we use to add. In subtraction, we will subtract. Now, you must be confused that whether we have to add or subtract, or in which question we have to add or in which question we have to subtract. So students, you might have noticed on page number 29 where addition story sums are there, or in the previous slide also, the worksheet which we were doing, the question ends like how many pencils in all or how many flowers in all. Remember one thing, wherever the word in all or all together will come, we will always add. Wherever the word how many left means the left word will come, we will subtract. Don't be confused students, as you will practice them, you will get used to it and you will recognize it more properly. Now, let's understand subtraction story sums with some examples, like we did in addition story sums. Here are some word problems for subtraction story sums. These are just examples for you to understand. Let's start with question number 1. Let me read it out for you. Number 1. Mary has 6 cherries. She eats 2 of them. How many cherries are left? Now students, as you can see, there is that word left, which means we have to subtract. Now which number will come in the first box and which number will come in the second box? Yes, the bigger number or the larger number will always come on the top or in the first box, which is 6. There were total number of 6 cherries, so we will write 6 minus, because there is that word left. How many cherries she ate? She ate 2 cherries, so we will write minus 2. 6 minus 2 equals to 4. Yes, next question. There are 8 orange slices in a plate. Pam eats 3 of them. How many orange slices are there in the plate now? Which means earlier there were 8 orange slices. Pam ate 3 of them, so we will subtract 3 from 8. In the first box we will write 8, then we will subtract 3, we will get the answer 5. There are 5 orange slices in the plate now. Third question. Tina has 5 candies. Candies, you understand? It's just like toffees. We gave 4 of them to Rosie. How many candies are left with Tina? Means there is one girl Tina and one girl Rosie. Tina is having 5 candies. And we took 4 candies from Tina and gave it to Rosie. Now we have to calculate how many candies are left with Tina. So we will subtract 4 candies from the total number of candies, which is 5. 5 minus 4 equals to 1, because she was having 5 candies. Now 4 candies she gave it to her friend Rosie, and how many she is having now? 1. You will understand it slowly, students. I know this is a bit difficult to you, but as you will read it daily and you will solve it by your own, then you will solve it properly. Let's get to next topic. Our next topic is understanding up to 50, which is on page number 31. Now what is short form and expanded form? Short form, as the name says, the shorter things. Expanded means the bigger ones or the longer ones. So, when we write a number as a sum of place value of its digit, the number is said to be expanded form, means in the longer form. And when we write a number using digits, the number is said to be in short form, that means the smaller one. Now, how will we understand the digits or the short form or the expanded form? We will learn place value, and after learning place value, it will be easy for you to understand short form and long form. Let's study place value now. Now, students, as you can see here, I have given a place value chart for you. What does place value means? Place value means the value represented by a digit in a number on the basis of its position in the number. That means at what position a number is, we will define it as its place value. For example, if I write 12, okay? So, in 12, 2 is at 1's place, because we always start place value from the right side. So, the rightmost digit is 1's, then second rightmost digit is 10's, then third digit is 100's. For now, we will study 1's and 10's only. So, you can take any two-digit number, let's say 42. Please write down 42 in your copies. Very good. Now, look at the number now. 42. 2 is at 1's place and 4 is at 10's place. Alright, so here we will study how expanded form and short forms are calculated with the help of 1's place and 10's place. We will study hundreds after our completion of up to 50. When we will study up to 100, then I will teach you hundreds place also. For now, just keep in mind that we will always start the place value from right hand side. Let us now study short form and long form or the expanded form. Students, don't be confused between short form and expanded form. In short form, we will write the answer in short. In expanded form, we will write the answer in expanded manner or the longer manner. So, let's discuss short form first. In short form, we are always given the digits in plus format, that is 10 plus 5 equals to dash. Now we will fill out the dash part. We will always remember that place value starts from right hand side, so we will write 5 on the right hand side, that is on the 1's place, and in 10 we take 1, or in 30, 40, we will not take 0. We will take the 10th place digit, which is 1. So, we will write 1 at 10th place. So, the answer will come out as 15. Second example. In the worksheet, it is given 60 plus 3. What will be the answer? Yes, we will write 3 at 1's place,
and 6 at 10th place. Why? Because 6 is at 10th place. If we take 60 as an individual number, 0 is at 1st place, so we need not write it. 6 is at 10th place, so we will write it. Always remember, students, we will not write 0. This is the short form. You need not calculate it or you need not add it. You will just write the answers. And it is very easy. Here are some more examples for you to solve it in your rough copy for your practice. Now, let's discuss expanded form. In expanded form, we are given the question in short form. So, we will write the answer in expanded form. For example, 28. Now, we know that 8 is at 1's place and 2 is at 10's place. So, we will write 2 with a 0 because it is at 10th place. 2. There is nothing at 1's place, so we will write 0. Plus 8. 8 is at 1's place. It is alone, the single number. So we will write 8. So the answer for 28 comes out to be 20 plus 8. In the worksheet, you can see 5th number, 49, equals to dash plus dash. We will write 40 plus 9. This will be the answer. Why? You all know, because of the place value system. You can also solve 5, 6, 7, 8 question in your rough copy for the practice of expanded form. In your rough copy, you can solve it. This is for your practice purpose only. I will provide you the book work in your portals or in your files. Now students, this is all we have for today. I know the class is a bit difficult, that is why it is quite short. You will take time to understand, but you will understand it very properly. But there are certain things we need to remember. Like the first thing is, wherever in story sums the word in all will come or all together will come, you will always add them. You never subtract the words in all or together. You will always make a sum and you will add them. These are the quick revisions or the things you will always remember so that it is easy for you to understand story sums. Similarly, when you will solve subtraction story sums, you will always look out for the words left or remain. Wherever the words left or remain will appear, you will always subtract the sum. Make out a sum and then subtract it. Put a subtraction sign on it. It is very easy for you to figure out on which story sum or which word problem you have to add or in which word problem you have to subtract. These are the words which will help you out in identifying whether you have to add or you have to subtract. That's all we have for today's class. Let's come to our homework section now. Homework. Do page number 29, 30, 31 and 32 in your mathematics textbook. You all must be having books by now. So, you will do these pages in your books. For all those who are not having books, I will provide you the keys for these questions. Also, who are having books with them, I will provide you the solutions for the same. Second point, you can practice the worksheets given in the video in your rough copy. Students, no need to do it in your classwork copy. You can practice them whenever you want to in your rough copy. There is no fixed time to complete it. You can practice two sums or two word problems daily. It is very easy and you will understand it very properly. I hope this whole session of maths today is helpful to you and you will learn story sums and short form and expanded form very easily. Thank you and take care.